So this area is still a work in progress.
Yes, 100%. Yeah, where the redwoods stop is basically where we're going to have to do some major edits to make this flow right into the top of this cliff here, which is huge. So you can look out over here and see down into the desert. It's just quite a big drop. Don't fall.
Nope, definitely want to jump there. Yeah,
and down there is probably we're gonna have.
So far, I'm seeing this desert is gonna be pretty big, actually.
Yeah, it's huge. That's actually about the size of the island.
Really?
It's funny. Yeah.
Interesting. So what's the estimate percentage that you think the map is? How far do you think you're into completing
like
the map?
30 right now? Maybe 30,
32? Do you have a goal for when the map will be done?
Yeah, it's hard to tell because Scorch is going to be so much different than what we've been doing. I'd probably say we're aiming for like a zone every like 2 weeks. A zone or two every 2 weeks now, so it's hard to tell. Progress will be coming very, very quickly.
Let's see, so how many people are working so far on Ragnarok?
Three at the moment. Here's a giant waterfalls.
Oh, this is nice.
I don't want to run into a rock, Jackson. Why don't you fly in there and then we'll...
okay. Let's,
So, like, in Valhalla, I remember you had caves...
Yes.
...behind the waterfalls. We'll just have something like that.
Yeah, I'm just gonna make sure I don't look like a fool. There we go. You got it? All right.
I think so just follow here. The way that I went.
All right.
Oh, nice.
I'll let you take the lead again.
No, it's cool. I just don't want to like run into a rock.
I got you. I do like end here.
I've done that before in Valhalla. It has happened to me. I was like, is this my cave entrance? Oh, wait, no, it's a rock.
Yeah, so it's pretty cool. Lots of spaces to build. That's really important to us. There's also a couple different entrances in and out of the different waterfalls.
Oh, this is nice.
Yeah, that one's really awesome. So up here is the Beaver Sanctuary start of the area, which is pretty cool. This is one of my favorite areas. Just like it just feels so different from what you normally get in Ark.
I really like the river here. It feels like feels so natural actually.
Yeah, it does. Here we'll stop up here on this thing. We'll look out.
Yeah, this is really cool. So how the spawn's gonna work? Are you gonna find like bears around here and things like that and fish? Okay.
Yeah, bears, beavers, fish. Yeah, the fish actually jump.
Yeah, the fish do jump out of the water.
Let's go down here. Let's come down here.
Really?
Sometimes they die, but it's okay. It's for the greater good.
It's for the greater good.
I
don't know. We'll have to catch one.
Yeah, there's one right there. Yeah, we gotta see if we can spear him or something. Let's just wait. You gotta be patient. Wait for the fish.
Oh,
there he goes.
I see it. I see it.
No.
Oh, he died.
You're
no.
Dying.
That was
okay.
For the greater good. Oh,
I see
one.
It. I see it. I see it. Oh, there wow.
Oh.
Impressive.
That's just more of a funny thing. You can actually like spear him and crossbow him when they're jumping up though.
Oh,
pretty cool.
I really like that. That's really cool. I will come here with my bear and come for some fish or one of those new seagulls that they added to.
Oh, yeah, that's true. That would actually be really good. I bet that would work. That's funny. I didn't even think about that. So here's something new that Jackson's been working on. They're called giant beaver dams. Beaver den? I don't know.
Yeah, they're beaver dens.
Yeah, you can actually, I think you can go into it. Is that right?
Yeah, you can go inside of it if you want. Oh, look, and there's an actual,
a little beaver dam next to it. Yeah.
That's funny.
So these beaver dams spawn normally like they do in Ark, and then we have these, which are managed by us, basically, which you can go into.
Oh, cool. So players will be able to find cement and trees and things like that.
What? He swam into it! What are the chances?
He's like, get out of my house, man!
Nice.
And you can actually collect the den and take the contents.
Okay.
Cool. If you want, but only from the inside. So you cannot collect it from the outside. You have to swim in there.
So will players be able to block those things? So I see like this like a pad and things like that. Or were you preventing players from blocking the beaver dens?
I think they function like the normal dams where you can't. I don't know. Actually, I have to look into that. I'm not sure.
If you build too close to them, they will not spawn in.
I see.
Gotcha.
And if there's a player too close by, they will not spawn in either. So it's definitely something that if you do want to take it and block it off, they won't return. So
yeah, there's certain things we can't really do much about, which is unfortunate. But so here's, let's see. That was really funny how you swam in there. That was
just a candid moment. I can't believe it. Over to the left, there should be the actual beaver, the other beaver.
Oh yes, yes.
Dam.
Let's go up to the top of the mountain over here. I like this place.
Gotcha. Where are we going? Oh.
Yep. The big mountain over here.
There's also a water well up at the top of you.
Hmm.
That's cool.
We saw one of our, I think, our favorite castle screenshots is a guy built on here, which is just ridiculous. He encompassed like the whole building, or the whole like mountaintop.
Oh, this is amazing.
I can't wait till everything's done. It's gonna look so good.
Right now,
you just have a view of unfinished landscape.
I can't wait though. It's like it looks like very promising for RP, PvE, PvP. So it's like a little bit of everything. So that's
really nice. We're really trying to make sure we think about everything when we're. We're taking all of our experience from both of our previous maps.
I see. So how does this work with the... I know you guys have been now being a sponsor back on the mod sponsor program. So how does that help you now with the working with the map?
Basically, we can spend more time on it. That's what it boils down to. We can take away from things we used to have to commit to in our non-ARC lives and spend more time on the map, which is great. It's good for everyone. Yeah, more progress gets done, things are polished more. It's really cool. It's a unique opportunity that I never thought we would have been able to get, which is just, hey, look, here's, keep doing what you love to do and we'll give you money for it, which is great. As long as we keep making good work, fantastic. So here's a nice area. This is the first place we actually added beavers in.
Oh, this is nice.
Got some fallen logs and some dams. There's dams.
Yeah, this is cool. I like this a lot for... It's a really nice view. Like, so far, every single area that I've seen so far has really nice view, you know? Mm-hmm. I can just stop there and be like, oh.
That's kind of what our goal is almost every time we make something is like, would this be cool? Would we build here? Yes or no? So...
Just an arc. It's loading.
It could be worse.
Loading game thing. Oh.
This is the entrance. Like, this isn't even the dungeon, really. This is just the entrance to the dungeon.
Whoa.
Yeah. Lots of angry bears. There's some loot in here. It's pretty easy to get, so it's not very good. It's like kind of standard loot. We have better loot as you go down into it. Actually, one of the things we could go and see is we can fly down here. There's a place where you can't fly anymore, you just can't get your flyer past it. I think the only thing you can take in there is like shoulder-mounted dinos.
Okay.
To enforce basically being a little more difficult than normal.
Right.
I don't know if I think the bears might attack our pterodons.
I can give it a...
No.
Go down here. Okay.
I don't think I want to go there, seeing all that blood splash.
No, you can go in there, you can do it. You're good.
Oh, what's in here? Oh, damn! Wow!
it's a little bit of we won't go any deeper, but it's a tale of the horrible things to come if you do proceed.
I like this a lot.
And the other
there's
way,
a,
where
a
we
bear,
didn't go.
It's a bear stuck in the ceiling.
Oh, yes. Yeah.
He,
that will make sense.
It'll make sense when you go farther along of what's happening.
Huh. If you've seen The Hills Have Eyes, then you'll know what's going on. I'm just kidding. Don't watch that movie. It's gross.
Huh.
But yeah, it'll make sense. So if you keep going the other way here, so the way I'm pointing right now, that's the rest. That's the actual dungeon.
So if I fly here,
you can try flying in there. Oh no, not there. This way. You won't be able to fly in there really.
This is one of the dungeons then. Okay, yeah. You pretty much can walk a dino in here.
Yeah, the point was to make it so people had to actually go in themselves.
It's scary down here, man.
I wouldn't go too far though, because you might see something you don't want to get into yet.
Oh.
He's running.
I'm running in.
Oh no.
I'm going in.
He's going in.
I'm going in. You say there's something you want to see. I'm seeing it.
Okay.
Oh, how big is this cave? I don't want to get lost.
It's huge. It's enormous. You will get lost.
Oh, whoa. What happened here?
Where is he going? I don't know where he went.
There's like a guy with two pickaxes. Sir, are you okay? Excuse me, sir. Indeed.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Actually, don't drop down here because
don't drop down there. Yeah, okay. It's gonna be tough.
It's a one-way cave.
Huh.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Yes. We try to warn people. Like, look, you gotta be ready. We're still in the safe zone right now, actually. So
yeah, I'm going back.
Yeah, let's go back.
We're in the safe zone. Is that the right way to go? Yeah, that is the right way to go.
I got excited and I see the guy, they're frozen. I was like, I might not want to go there.
Actually, what we should show is, you can see it from here. That's cool. If you look down in the bay here, you can see the top of a sunken thing. A boat. It's a boat. And then next to that is actually the cave that goes up into that huge cave that we saw earlier.
I don't see it.
Oh. It's harder to see when you get closer. It's right under where I am right now.
No, I see like... Oh, yeah, I see it. Okay.
Yeah, you can...
Yeah, we can actually land... you can land next to that wood...
I can land there. Oh, I see it. I see it. Oh, this is nice. Cool.
So next to that is actually an entrance to the large kind of foggy cave that we were in earlier. Okay. So the tunnel goes all the way through here up into the mountain and then into the cave. All
right. So let's go down into here. This is the entrance area for the jungle dungeon. We'll drop right down into here. Whoop. Oh, whoops. No, stop following. Get out of here.
This is nice.
Okay, I think I turned off God mode and infinite stats. I think I'm okay.
Ooh, this looks dangerous.
It is dangerous.
Oh, whoa.
Oh, God! I'm down.
Whoa.
Careful. Oh. Watch out. There's pads on the floor. If you step on them, you get shot. Careful.
Oh, this is nice. See, can I step on
some of them? Some of them are good, some of them are bad.
I see. I was when I got in, as soon as I loaded, I got instantly hit.
Yeah, we're still working on some of the loading mechanics, but Jackson, unfortunately, here didn't turn out so well.
Oh, no.
Let me try to get him out of here.
Take me out.
Oh, this is nice. Right. This is really cool.
Wake me up.
I guess we can force feed you like stim berries or something.
I'm almost awake.
Okay, all right. So we're also working on performance. This area in here is a little laggy for some reason, and so we're still working on that. But
okay. Huh.
But we'll walk through God again, and then go from there. All right. Okay, I just drag Jackson with us.
I'm almost awake.
I might be in God mode again.
Okay. Oh, and we're good.
Are you good? All right. So let's go down here.
Woo!
Oh,
Careful, careful. There's a drop. Careful.
Are you planning? Oh, I see.
Oh yeah, the drop. Oh man, I always miss this joke.
Yeah.
Oh, I made it today though.
I made it too.
Nice.
Yeah, don't worry about it. Yeah.
Oh, you guys flying over?
Yep.
Whoa. So, are you planning to add more traps, like Indiana Jones kind of traps? You know what I'm saying?
That's definitely the idea. Yeah.
Oh.
Jackson,
we got
you
some cool things planned. Oh no, no, you keep going.
Why? I don't want to get lost. Fine. No, it'll just be embarrassing. All right.
Very slowly.
So like some plant X and Y down here. Bunch of bugs. See. This is kind of cool. Not kind of cool. This is cool.
Oh yeah, you know where to go from here.
What happened here? Sure, are you okay?
No. So over here is a little secret place. So if you don't want to go down and fight stuff, you can be sneaky.
Which way? Oh, I see.
The vine.
Oh,
yeah.
Well, I can actually walk on the vine. Oh. Oh man. That gives me vertigo. Oh boy.
You do not want to fall down
there. There's a reason we're laughing. I've seen a few moments here. All right. Are we gonna hit the web things, Jackson?
That's down below.
Okay. We should do that.
Okay.
This definitely gives me this Indiana Jones kind of feeling.
That was definitely some inspiration for the cave.
Oh man, the snake slithers down below. That's terrifying.
Yeah, there's a lot of bad stuff in here. A lot of bad stuff. Hello, snakes.
Huh. It's nice. So as well, players will be able to find like really good end loot and things like that.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, there's actually one right up there.
We'll get there in a moment.
But oh yeah, and the end loot will be.
You know what I'm trying to get to.
I know.
Oh, that looks dangerous.
It is. I'm just... We usually.
I'm not ready for it. I'm flying.
Oh man. Yeah, I was gonna say, this is definitely a fly area. You do not want to. This would be a jumping puzzle across.
Let's see, would Blaze be able to use like grapple hooks and things like that? Or do you. Okay.
Yeah, you can
grappling hook if you want to. If you
don't want
to. Yeah.
Or you want to make it.
Frustrating to people.
If you're an adrenaline junkie, then you have a jumping puzzle at your disposal.
Okay.
With severe punishments.
Yeah, with some severe punishments.
So there's a bunch of loot around here, some monsters. There is more to this. I don't know if we should keep going, because it's kind of a special surprise.
It's up to you.
Oh, I want
to
see a surprise.
Yeah. It's up to you, man.
I want to see it.
You want to see it? Okay, we'll go see it. Right.
You can also climb to the top and pick up that loot at the top there.
Yes. Is loot here at the top? How do I get to it?
Mm-hmm.
I think you're going the right way. Yeah, you are going the right way.
Oh. It's really hard to see it. Okay. Oh, I see.
Yeah. See.
Like, with all those bats around me, if I was in good mode, I would have died immediately.
It's a tough... People go in groups, like...
People go in with a battle plan for this dungeon, essentially.
I need to be level 80. Okay, cool.
All right, we'll keep going. Let's see. It's over this way, right?
Gotta
go through this
Yes, yes, that way.
Yeah.
So these most of these bridges are custom assets and things like that, right?
Kind of. That's actually a good example of what we've repurposed with Ark.
Okay.
It's just some other bits of Ark that Jackson actually put together, and then we just group them together and they form a different function.
Nice.
Oh, that's right. That lava still doesn't work.
Oh, is the lava?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's easy.
Okay.
Actually, I'll write that down. And still bugs to fix.
I understand it.
Yeah, as the workshop page says, like it's fun to play on, but
it's still working.
Only if you're okay with bugs, and because it's heavy work in progress.
There is the artifact.
Yeah, this is the artifact there. This is another
Whoa.
Fly zone if you want, or you can jump across the lava.
Okay. Think I'll rather fly.
No, you can't jump across the boxes below. There's a specific way to jump to get to the artifact, but it is a treacherous journey.
30. There we go.
Okay.
So if you happen to bring a pick in here, you can get some loot. Also, there's actually a secret. Oh, you're not over here yet. Sorry.
Almost there.
It's cool. So there's crystals here, and you can break them. And then go through here.
Secret entrance.
Oh, oh gosh. He's right here.
Is it?
Yeah. Why don't you just go ahead and walk into the room?
Oh, he won't. He won't. He's not going to see anybody.
Oh, because I'll. Oh, yeah. Break that. There we go. You want to make the sacrifice or want me to?
You make the sacrifice.
Okay.
Oh, sacrifice. Yeah. Oh. Do it. Make the sacrifice. That's pretty good.
I think I did.
I don't know. Oh, you did.
Oh.
Oh,
jeez.
Oh! Oh.
He got me.
Whoa!
You made the ultimate sacrifice.
A lava elemental. Huh. Impressive. Ow. So how do you... Does he just spawn there, or are you just walking there?
He's a boss. He spawns in there.
Oh, I see. So... Oh, this reminds me a lot of... Diablo 3 boss fights. now, if players kill this mini boss, will they be able to find loot or anything like
yes,
that?
Yes, there's lots loot. There's loot surrounding this area as well as on top of that statue up above.
No, I'm saying, also, like, if they kill this lava boss, will they be able to obtain something, or would that be
They will obtain a lot of really good loot. Now,
it's hard to kill.
It's very difficult to kill him, but the rewards are massive.
Okay. Oh.
So he's worth your time if you want to have an extra challenge, an arc, and something to fight.
Oh, that's cool.
I'll get the underwater stuff ready.
There's one thing.
Mess around with that.
There's one thing I really wanted to see in arc, like, you know, like WoW raids where you go to a cave and fight a mini boss and thing, high end loot, things like that.
Yeah.
That's what we wanted to do with Valhalla originally, and Jackson's help basically making that a reality with what we're doing now.
I see. So. With that regard, how many raid dungeons are you planning to add with mini boss and things like
that? Our plan is one per zone. In total maybe like 7. I don't know. It's tough to tell. It really is.
That's awesome.